The angel of the Lord brought tidings to Mary, and she conceived by the Holy Ghost. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen.
And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt amongst us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of thy Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion may we come to know the glory of his resurrection. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti, Amen. In gloria volontari Dei, benedictifica iubitutum eum. Iudica me Deus adigenitos in mem de gente non sancta ab nomine nemine quod lo sorro a me. Quae tuus Deus futitum me, cor de punistis, cor infistis in cegu, dum effigi me, nemicus. Evite lucem tuum e veritatem tuum, misum e deduxerunt in montum sanctum tuum, et in tabernacula tua. Eit in sloi volatare Dei, de infinitifica libum tutum me. Quod te gutib in citra, Deus Deus meus, quae fisis anima mea, quare conturbas me. Spere in Deo quonem ac hoc confidebo iri, salutari vultus me, et Deus meus. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritus Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. In tuoi volontari Dei, pendem crucificat iuvum tutum me. Auditori nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci caelum et terram. Confitio per ricutente, via de Maria, sempre vigile, via dell'Italia, non via più arriva a Cristo, santi costi, spetto, fanno via più arriva a Maria, via a nome di santi di buoni spazi, qui è l'età di miscogitazione, devo recopere, mea maxima culpa, ed io prego, beata Maria, sempre vigile, via di Natale, ma tanti, non via di Duano Battista, santi costi, spetto, fanno, via di Duano Maria, via a nome di santo di buoni spazi, orare con me, donne in tempo. Miseria Confitio Deo omnipotente, beate Maria sempre vergine, beato Michele arcangelo, beato Giovanni Battista, sanctis apostolis Petro et Paolo, omnibus sanctis et tibi pater, qui ad caminis cogitatione, verbo et opere, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ed io preco beatam Mariam sempre virgine, beatum Michaelum arcangelum, beatum Ioannem Baptistam, sanctos apostolos Petrum et Paulum, omnes sanctos et te pater, orare pro me ad Dominum Deum nostrum. Misereatur vesu omnipotens Deus, et missis peccatis vestris peducat vos ad vitam aeternam. Amen. Indulgentiam assumptionem et remissionem peccatorum nostrum tibuat nobis omnipotens misericus Dominus. Amen. Deus tu conversus specificatis nos, et flems tu letavit volinter, os servi nobis Domini misericordiam tuam, et salutare tuum dai nobis. Domine exaudi rationem meam, et clamor meus et te venia. Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo.
Oremus. Cio qui credeidi et certus in quia potens est depositum mem se barri in illum Dei, justus iudex. Domine probastim et convistime, tu convisti sessionem meam et resurrectionem meam. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritus Sanctus, sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Cio qui credeidi et certus in quia potens est depositum mem se barri in illum Dei, tium Gustex iudex. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison. Gloria in excelsis Deo, et in terra pax omnibus bone voluntatis. Laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te. Gratias agimus tibi propter magnum gloriam tuam. Domine Deus, ex celestis, Deus Pater omnipotens, Domine Filio unigenite, Iesu Christe, Domine Deus, omnius Dei, Filius Patris, qui tollis peccatum mundi, miserere nobis, qui tollis peccatum mundi, suscipe deprecationem nostram, qui sedis ad extram Patris, miserere nobis. Quoniam tu solus sanctus, tu solus Dominus, tu solus altissimus, Iesu Christe, cum Sanctu Spiritu in gloria Dei Patris. Amen. Ex vobis et cum Spiritu Tuo, ordemus. Deus, cui universum mundum beati pauli apostoli predicatione docuisti, da nobis quesmus, utque eius hodie conversionem colimus, per eius et exemple gradiamus. Per Dominum nostrum, Iesu Christum, Filium Tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Oremus. Deus, qui beato Petro, apostolo tuo, collatis clavibus regni celestis, lingantil atque solvendi pontificium tradidisti, concede, ut intercessionis Deus auxilio, et peccatorum nostrorum exibus liberemur, qui vivis et regnas cum Deo Patria in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Lectio actuum apostolorum. Indiebus illis, Saulus, aut hoc spirans minarum, accedis et discipulus Domini, accesit et principiem sacerdotum, et petiet ab eo epistolas in Damascum et synagogas. Ut si quos invenissit huius viros et mulieres, vinctos per duceret in Jerusalem. Et cum ite faceret, contigit ut ad apocinquarvit ad Damasco, et subito cecum fulsit eum lux de celo. Et cadens in terra, maudivit vocem dicentem sibi, Saule, Saule, quid me persequeris? Qui dixit, qui est Domine? Et ide, Ebus sum Iesus, quem tu persequeris, turum est tibi contra stimulum calcitrale. Et tremens ex stupens dixit, Domine, quid me fis facere? Et Dominus ad eum, Surge, et ingretere, civitatem, et ibi dicetur tibi quid Deo porte ad facere. Vi autem ili, qui comitabantur cum eo, Saban stupificati audientes quidem vocem, neminem autem videntes. Surrexit autem Saulus de terra, per pretisque oculis nihil videbat, et manus autem idum trahentes introduxerunt Damascum. Et erat ibi tribus diebus non videns, et non meducavit neque vivit. Erat autem quidam discipulus Damasci, nomine Ananias, et dixit ad illum in visu Dominus. Anania, et ille eit, ecce ego, Domine, et Dominus et eum, Surge, et vade in vicum qui vocato rectus, et querre in domo Iude Saulum, Domine Taresensem, ecce enim aurat. Et vidit virum Arinaiam nomini, introentum et imponentum sibi manus ut fissum recipiat. Respondet autem Ananias, Domine, audivia multis de viro hoc, quantum mala fecerit sanctis tuis in Jerusalem, et hic habet potestatem et principibus sacerdotum allegandi omnes, qui invocant nomen tuum. Dixit autem et eum Dominus, Vade, quoniam vasi lectionis est mihi iste, ut portet nomen meum coram gentibus et regibus et filiis Israel. Ego enim ostendam ili quanta opoteat eum pro nomine meo pati. Et abiet Ananias, et introvivit in domum, et imponens ei manus dixit, Saule frater, Dominus misit me Iesus, qui apparuit tibi in via qua veniebas, ut videas et implearis Spiritus Sanctum. Et confesti unciciderunt ab oculis eus sanqua squame, et visum recipi, et surgens baptisatus est, et come cipisi cibum computatus est. Quod autem condisciculis quierant Damasci per dies aliquot, et continuo in synagogis praeticabat Iesum, quoniam hic est filius Dei. Subhebant autem omnes qui audiebant, et dicebant, Nonne hic est, qui expulabat in Jerusalem eius, qui vocabat nomini sunt, et huc ad hoc venit ut ventus illos duceret et principe sacerdotum? Saulus autem multum magis convalescebat et confundebat Iudeos, qui habitabant in Damasci, affirmans quoniam hic est Christus. Deo gratias. Qui operatus est Petro in apostolatum, operatus est et mihi intergentes, et connuverum gratiam Dei quae dateres mihi. Gratia Dei me vacua non fuit, sed gratia eius sempre me mane. Tu es vasi lectionis Sancte Pauli Apostole, me regines glorificandus, predicato veritatis et docta gentium in filiae veritate, per te omnes gentes connuverum gratiam Dei. Intercede pro nobis ad Deum, qui te elegit. Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo,
sequentia Sancti Evangelii secundum Matteum. Gloria tibi, Domine. In illo tempore, dixit Petrus ad Iesum, ecce nos reliquimus omnia et secundi sumus Te, quid ergo erit nobis? Iesus autem dixit illis, Amen dico vobis, quod vos qui secundi estis me, in regeneratione, cum sedevit filius hominis in sede maestasis sue, sedevitis et vos super sedes duodecem, judicantes duodicem tribus Israel. Et omnis qui reliquerit Domum, vel fratres, aut sorores, aut patrem, aut matrem, aut uxorem, aut filius, aut atros, propter nomen meum, centum promecipiet, et vitam aeternam possidebit. Laus tibi Christi.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. At this time, Saul, with every breath he drew, still threatened the disciples of the Lord with massacre. And now he went to the high priest and asked him for letters of commendation to the synagogues at Damascus, so that he could arrest all those that he found, the men and women who belonged to the way, and bring them back to Jerusalem. Then on his journey, when he was nearly at Damascus, a light from heaven shone suddenly about him. He fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, Saul, Saul, why dost thou persecute me? Who art thou, Lord? He asked. And he said, I am Jesus, whom Saul persecutes. This is a thankless task of thine, kicking against the goad. And he, dazed and trembling, asked, Lord, what wilt thou have me do? Then the Lord said to him, Rise up and go into the city, and there thou shalt be told what thy work is. His companions stood in bewilderment, hearing the voice speak, but not seeing anyone. When he rose from the ground, he could see nothing, although his eyes were open, and they had to lead him by the hand to take him into Damascus. Here, for 3 days, he remained without sight and neither ate nor drank. There was in Damascus a disciple named Ananias. To him the Lord called in a vision, Ananias, here I am. Lord, he answered, and the Lord said to him, Rise up and go to the road called Straight Street, and inquire at the house of Judas for a man of Tarsus named Saul. Even now he is at his prayers, and he has had a vision of a man called Ananias coming in and laying hands on him to cure him of blindness. At this, Ananias answered, "Lord, many have told me about this man and all the hurt he has done to thy saints in Jerusalem, and he has come here with authority from the chief priest to imprison all those who would call upon thy name." But the Lord said to him, "Go on thy errand. This is a man I have chosen to be the instrument for bringing my name before the heathen and their rulers, and before the people of Israel too. I have yet to tell him how much suffering he will have to undergo for my name's sake." So Ananias set out, and as soon as he came into the house, he laid his hands upon him and said, "Brother Saul, I have been sent by that Lord Jesus who appeared to thee on thy way as thou camest here. Thou art to recover thy sight and be filled with the Holy Spirit." And with that, a kind of film fell away from his eyes, and his sight was recovered. He rose up and was baptized. And now, when he had taken food, his strength returned to him. For some days he lived with the disciples at Damascus, and from the first in the synagogues he preached that Jesus was the Son of God. All those who heard it were amazed. "Why," they said, "is not this the man who brought ruin on all those who evoked this name? When he was in Jerusalem, the man who came here for the very purpose of arresting such people and presenting them to the chief priests." But Saul was inspired with ever greater strength and silenced the Jews who lived at Damascus by showing them clearly that this was the Christ. A Gospel reading from St. Matthew. At this time, Peter said to Jesus, "And what of us who have forsaken all and follow thee? What is left for us?" Jesus said to them, "I promise you, in the new birth, when the Son of Man sits on the throne of his glory, you also will sit there on 12 thrones, you who have followed me, and shall be judges over the 12 tribes of Israel. And every man that has forsaken home or brothers or sisters or father or mother or wife or children or lands for my name's sake shall receive his reward 100-fold and obtain everlasting life."
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Carissimi, beloved in Christ, welcome to this broadcast Mass on this, the Feast of the Conversion of St. Paul the Apostle. And what a wonderful occasion, and what a wonderful feast, but what a wonderful occasion this feast day commemorates. We, of course, who are practicing the faith today, have so much to be thankful and grateful for concerning the conversion of St. Paul. And what a wonderful story it is of the conversion, let alone the beautiful narrative description that Patrick very kindly just read for us, but the fact that Saul, who of course it was at the feet of Saul that the stoners had put their cloaks at the martyrdom of Stephen, Saul, who had deliberately sought to condemn the followers of the way, the Christians, who had already instigated and overseen the arrests and executions of other Christians in Jerusalem, as Ananias later refers to. He, who then in many ways was a persecutor, a murderer of Christians, and yet one who was at the same time, remember, thinking himself righteous. Saul, as he was a very learned man of the Jewish law. He was a Pharisee. Remember, he had studied under Gamaliel, that great Pharisee and doctor of the law, together with Stephen, whom later he oversaw the execution of. Here is Saul, whose name is well known throughout Jerusalem by all who would deem themselves righteous Jews, who would deem themselves righteous adherents of God's law. And yet, Saul becomes Paul and becomes one of the greatest exponents of the gospel of Jesus Christ, who is appointed by Jesus deliberately to proclaim his gospel to the Gentiles. Paul, who as Saul knew, or thought he knew, the Old Testament, who thought he knew the covenant between God and man, who suddenly has revealed to him, or suddenly for whom it becomes a great revelation, a great theophany, a great epiphany concerning the nature of God and of Christ and of the new covenant worked through Christ by virtue of his passion, his death, and his resurrection. Saul, who becomes Paul, is one of the few after the apostles to see the risen Lord. But he is one of the greatest minds, to have all that knowledge of the law, to recognize the fulfillment of it by Christ Emmanuel, by Christ the Word made flesh, by Christ the risen Messiah. This, my brothers and sisters, should inspire all of us who think ourselves unworthy, who think ourselves beyond the pale of redemption. The example and the conversion of Saul to Paul should remind us that yes, there is still hope for those who have faith, for those who practice charity, who live in love with God and with each other. There is always hope. The three great theological virtues, which of course it is Saul who became Paul who wrote us about. Faith, hope, and charity. And the greatest of these is charity, sacrificial love. And Saul, who had bethought himself to be living already in love with God, who had already sacrificed much of his life and indeed of his passions and cares for the world in pursuing and studying the law of God, yet finds that he must ultimately pay an even greater sacrifice. He must sacrifice all his preconceptions. He must sacrifice all that he thought was true and realize how wrong he had been. Imagine, if you will, my brothers and sisters, what must have been going through Saul's head those 3 days when he could not see. 3 days in a strange place. 3 days after a changed mission, when he had already set out to Damascus thinking he was doing and was about to God's work, to have been told by God himself that he was kicking against the goad. The sudden realization of what he had done in persecuting the church. The sudden realization the sudden guilt, perhaps, the sudden sorrow and pain and internal torment, remembering the stoning of his cousin Stephen, remembering the pain and the hardship and the suffering he had inflicted on those who had innocently recognized and accepted Christ as the Messiah. How awful those 3 days of darkness must have been for him. And no wonder that he writes to us about baptism later, of dying to the old man, of dying to the old self, and rising a new man, a new creation in God through baptism. For sure, how significant his baptism must have been to him. That sudden realization that it was all the time God whom he had been hurting. Saul, Saul, why dost thou persecute? Notice here, my brothers and sisters, the self-identification of our Lord Jesus Christ with us, with those who are the members who make up his body. Saul, Saul, why dost thou persecute me? When Jesus had been already dead and buried, and of course risen, long before this conversion of Saul, Christ is identifying himself with the saints, with those sinners striving to be saints, with those who have recognized and accepted him as the Messiah and as the Son of God. Christ identifies himself with the suffering church. Think, my brothers and sisters, then, of our brothers and sisters around the world now suffering. And see how their suffering is also then our suffering. And recognize how Christ identifies himself with those who suffer for his sake. Remember the great hope and promise of eternal life with him, as the gospel today has reminded us. Those who suffer for my name's sake, those who forsake mother and father, sister and brother, or even lands. Think of our brothers and sisters who are fleeing that persecution. And think of our own response. Think of those 5 questions that we've been thinking about during Advent. Think of those 5 questions. Where were you when I was hungry, when I was naked, when I was thirsty, when I was hung, when I was in prison, when I was sick? And think of our brothers and sisters who are being persecuted for their faith. And ask ourselves, are we doing enough in charity, in sacrificial love for them? How beautiful the description of Ananias, of that faithful disciple of the Lord, who in fear and trembling, yet chosen by Christ for that very special task, laying on hands, of praying and anointing, and of receiving and baptizing and restoring to Saul his sight, completing his conversion and his change into Paul, the great apostle of the Lord. Think of the faith of Ananias. Think of the promptings that you may have received. Think of the promptings, perhaps, that you have not been aware of, because you have not been open, or as open as you might have been, to the promptings of Christ, to the promptings of the Holy Ghost, to the promptings of God the Father. Yet in fear and trembling of persecution, Ananias yet lived in holy fear, yet lived in awareness of God and was open to His will. And though we may not receive quite a prompting as Ananias did, though we may not have received quite the call to conversion that Saul did, yet even so, those who are seekers after truth, whose minds and hearts are open, will receive promptings. And those who are open to discerning God's will, it will be made known to us. But we have the strength that Ananias had to accept that prompting, to accept that voice or vision in a dream, to gather ourselves up and give our answer, give our fiat to God's will. Even if it means going in fear and trembling to somebody like Saul. And thinking of Saul again and those 3 days in darkness, suddenly, at the touch of Ananias' hand, at the touch of Christ, through Ananias, the scales fell from his eyes. The suggestion, of course, is that they were perhaps physical scales. But the inference, of course, is spiritual and doctrinal. And after 3 days in the darkness, Saul, having come to his senses and having reconciled within himself what he had seen and heard, now sees with clarity, eyes of faith, now accepts and now rejoices through baptism, the restoration and the healing that Christ has afforded to him. Now this same restorative touch is made available by God's grace to us in the sacraments. We who avail ourselves of the sacrament of penance and of the sacrament of the Eucharist are too restored, healed, and forgiven. The same risen Lord, the same Word made flesh at Bethlehem, touches us as he touched Saul, speaks to us as he spoke to Saul, through the scriptures, through his word revealed, through his fulfillment of all that had been foretold. And the same scriptures that we ourselves read and can hear, and hear at every Mass. How wonderful it is that in the liturgy, the invitation to come and see echoes throughout the centuries. In those words of St. John the Baptist, Ecce omnes Dei, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. And how we are invited to respond, to make that exclamation of faith that impressed even our Lord, who when he first heard it said, I have not heard such faith as this in all of Israel. Those words of the centurion, Domine non sum dignus, Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come under my roof, but speak the word only. Let us, my brothers and sisters, take from today's feast an invitation to continue our pilgrimage of faith, our spiritual development, our growth toward holiness, taking heart from the example of Saul who became Paul, that he who had committed such heinous crimes against his fellow man, and even against God, could yet be healed, restored, and forgiven. And we, who may have been forgiven by comparison, much lesser degrees of sin, what faith then should we engender within ourselves to fulfill those words of the centurion? Let us, my brothers and sisters, desire again today, as we thought about on the circumcision of the Lord and for the octave of the Epiphany, to renew our baptism vows every morning, to think every day, death to the old self, and let's begin anew, refreshed and enlightened by that same Holy Ghost who ignited that flame within Paul's heart to live truly in love with God and with man, and tell others of the gospel of the good news of Jesus Christ, who is God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Credo in unum Deum, Patrem omnipotentem, Factorum Caeli et Terrae, Visibilium omnium et invisibilium, et in unum Dominum, Iesum Christum, Filium Dei Unigenitum, et ex Patri nantum ante omnia saecula, Deum de Deo lumen de lumine, Deum verum de Deo vero, genitum non factum consustantialem Patri, pecum omnia factus sum. Qui prote nos homines et prote nostrum salutem, descendite Caelis, et dicandatus este Spiritus Sancto ex Maria Virgine, et homo factus est. Crucifixus etiam pro nobis Pontio Pilato passus et sepultus est, et resurrexit tertii dei secundus scripturas, et descendit in caelum, sedet dextram Patris, et iterum venturus est cum gloria militari vivos et mortuos, cuius veri non efinis. Et in spiritum sanctum dominum et vivificantem, qui ex patri proceedi, qui cum patri et filius emoledoretur cum glorificatur, qui locutus est per prophetas. Et unam sanctam catholicam et apostolicam ecclesiam, confitio unum baptismo remissionem peccatorum, et expecto resurrectionem mortuorum, et vitam venturi saeculi. Amen.
Dominus obiscum,
et cum spirito tuo.
Oremus. Mihi autem nimis honorati sunt amici tui Deus, nimis confortatus est principatus eorum.
Orate fratres, ut meum vestrum sacrificium acceptabile fiat ad Deo Patrem omnipotentem. Suscipia Dominus sacrificium de Marcus, sum alma gloria in nomine sui dignitatem populus et pros nostra ecclesia sua sancta. Romia secula seculorum.
Amen.
In Dominus obiscum,
ecum spiritu tuo,
susum corda,
habemus et Dominum.
Gratias damus Domino Deo nostro.
Dignum et justum est.
Bene, dignum et justum est etiam salutare, te Domine supplicite ex orare, ut regum tuum pastra aeterna non desinas, sed per beatus apostolos tuos, continua protectione custodias. Ut istem rhetoribus obedecur, quos operis qui vicarius et impotulisti praesa et pastores. Et ideo cum angelis et arcangelis controlis et dominationibus, conque omni ministra celestis exercitus, in un gloria et tuae caritas, sine fine dicentes. Sanctus, 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 Dominus Deus Sanctus, venis in celi et terra gloria tua, hosanna in excelsis. Benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, hosanna in excelsis.
Thank you.
Mia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus. Rece ti salutaribus moniti et divina institutione formati. Audemus dice. Pater noster qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum de nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentatione, sed libera nos a malo. Omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Ex Domini sit semper vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo.
Thank you.
ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccatum mundi. Domine non sum ignus, ut in tre subtectum vel, sed tantum dic verbo, et senabitur anima mea. Domine non sum ignus, ut in tre subtectum vel, sed tantum dic verbo, et senabitur anima mea. Domine non sum ignus, ut in tre subtectum vel, sed tantum dic verbo, et senabitur anima mea. Brothers and sisters watching Mass online and unable therefore to receive the Blessed Sacrament, we invite you now to make an act of spiritual communion, the words for which we'll find below your viewing screen. My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee, and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen.
Amen dico vobis, quod vos qui requisis omnia, et secuti estis me, centuplum ecipietis, et vitam aeternam possidebis. Thank you.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo,
oremus. Sanctificati Domine salutari mysterium, quesimus, ut nobis eius non desitur ratio, cuius nos donasti patrocinio, cumendare. Per Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum, Filium Tuum, et tecum divita regna ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus. Laetificet nos Domine mulus oblatum, ut sicut in apostolo tuo Petro te mirabilem predicamus, sic per inum tuae sumamus in urgentia lagitate. Per Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum, Filium Tuum, et tecum vivit et regnat ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo,
ite missa est,
Deo gratias.
Sed nomen Domini benedictum, ex hoc nunc et usque in saecula, auditorium nostrum in nomine Domini, qui fece caelum et terram, benedicat vos omnipotens Deus. Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo,
initium sancti Evangelii secundum Ioannem.
Gloria tibi, Domine.
In principio erat verbum, et verbum erat apu Deum, et Deus erat verbum. Hoc erat in principio apu Deum, omnia per ipsum factum sunt, et sine ipso factum est nihil quo factum est. In ipso vita erat, et vita erat lux omnia. Et lux in tenebris luce, et tenebre non comprehendere. Fuit homo missus ad eo quod nomen erat Ioannes, ec venit in testimonium, ut testimonium viverentem lumen eo omnes credunt intra illum. Non erit in eum, secum testimoni vivere tu lumen. Erat lux vera, qua luminat omnem hominem venientem in hoc mundum. In mundo erat, mundus prepsum factus est, mundus er non coniorum. In proprio venit et seum non receperum. Qua quod autem receperum teum, deideres podestatem filios Dei fiei, vis qui venit in nomine eus, qui non est sanguinibus, necos untati panis, necos untati viri, sed ex Deo natus. Et verbum caro factum est, et habitabit in nobis et vivimus gloria Deus, gloria quod unigenite a Pater, danum gratia et veritatis. Deo gratias.